How cool is that? My friend recently got a 3D printer and just sent me a 3D printed Gaming Careers logo keyring. It's been almost 7 months now since the last major release of OBS. If you remember, that was the big overhaul that they did of the NVENC encoder, bringing some massive improvements to how your stream impacts your computer performance. This one doesn't have any major implications like that, but it does have a lot of user requested features that have been implemented and things that are going to make managing your live stream whilst you are live much easier. There are some new features in how OBS handles recordings, something called dynamic bitrate, as well as custom browser docs and a whole lot more. So we'll dive into it after a quick message from our video sponsor. Focus is a minimally designed stream package from our friends at Nerd or Die, featuring a simple and clean look while still giving almost endless customization. The overlay pack has 7 different color options, and the widgets and alerts include custom fields that let you change the color, the language, animation directions, and much, much more. Save 10% at checkout using the link and code in the description. So let's dive straight in with one of the most important features, I think, which is called dynamic bitrate. This is especially useful for those of you that have ever experienced any kind of network congestion or drop frames in your stream. OBS can now automatically lower your bitrate whilst you are streaming if it notices any kind of network congestion. Typically, what would happen before this feature was implemented is if you were, say, streaming at 6,000 kilobits per second, and you started to have some kind of network problem that caused OBS to have to drop frames, your Twitch viewers would start to see choppy or laggy video playback because Twitch wouldn't actually be getting all of the video data that it required for a smooth playback function. With this feature enabled now though, OBS can then drop this 6,000 kilobits per second to 4,000 or 2,500 or whatever it requires to give a smooth playback and ensure that no frames are dropped. This is a much better experience for your viewers because it will still be smooth playback, although at a lower quality, but then OBS will of course bring your bitrate back up once the network congestion is gone. This is kind of similar to things that on-demand streaming services like Netflix have been doing for a while. If you're watching a show on Netflix at 4K and your download rate starts to suffer, Netflix automatically swaps out the 4K resolution for maybe 1080p dynamically whilst it's still playing back, so you actually don't notice any stutter in playback, although the quality and the bitrate have changed behind the scenes. The second feature that we're going to be talking about that's new in OBS Studio version 24 are called custom browser docs. Now, over the past year, we've seen the rise of alternative streaming applications, things like Streamlabs OBS and Stream Elements OBS Live. And one of the features that really attracts people to these pieces of software is the ability to have your stream chat, as well as things like your recent events, inside of the streaming window. Now, in the last version of OBS, OBS version 23, they introduced the ability to link your account with Twitch or with YouTube and bring things in like your YouTube or Twitch chat, as well as things like your stream information that you could then update from within OBS. In this version, however, you can now add any web page as a dockable panel within OBS. So you could add things like your Streamlabs or Stream Elements recent events so that you make sure that you don't miss anybody subscribing or donating to your stream. You could add something like your Twitter's composed tweet panel. I'm trying to think of ideas now, but I'm pretty sure the community is going to come up with some incredible ideas of what you can dock within OBS now as a web page. This now truly allows you to customize OBS to look exactly as you want it, as you can dock any kind of functionality that's available on a web page within OBS. Next, we have the ability to pause recordings. Now, apparently this was one of the most requested features from the community, people wanting the ability to use OBS for recordings, which you can obviously do, but actually be able to pause that recording whilst they take a break or rewrite their script or do whatever they need to do and then click resume to then resume recording. Personally, I think that if you want to grow as a content creator and a streamer, learning to edit your clips is going to be a really useful skill to know, because you're going to need to be able to grow on multiple different platforms to actually grow your stream. So personally, I don't think this is the biggest feature. It's really not that hard to record the whole of your stream and then bring that clip into some editing software and then cut out the dead silences or the boring bits or whatever you want to cut out. But apparently there was a lot of people that wanted to be able to pause the recording and then not have to deal with any editing software. So I guess if you are one of those people, this is probably a huge feature for you. An important thing to note here is that if you are streaming whilst recording, you need to ensure that you are not sharing the encoder. So if you are streaming whilst recording, go into your settings and make sure you aren't recording with the same as stream option if you are using the same encoder. The final thing to do with recording that they've implemented is they have now changed the default recording format to MKV. Something I have harped on about in pretty much every single video to do with recording is saying to make sure that you're using MKV because it's firstly more reliable in case of any crashes or maybe a blue screen, but secondly because it supports multiple audio tracks. They've also made some improvements to how you actually deal with the preview window and arranging your sources within that window. In the previous version, version 23, they did add some improvements to this UI so that you could see when you were positioning sources outside of the preview. And in this release, they've added the ability to be able to drag and highlight multiple different sources to move them all at once. Also, whilst we're on the topic of the preview, if you disable the preview whilst you are streaming to save on some system resources, which I definitely recommend you do, you'll no longer need to right-click to re-enable the preview. There's a new button there instead, which I imagine is due to the number of new users that didn't know how to get their preview back. The last couple of things that I will mention is that browser source audio now have dedicated audio controls in your mixer. So you can control volumes, filters, effects, you can disable monitoring, and you can save it to a separate audio track in recordings. Finally, OBS have updated some of the software that they use internally, things like X264, FFmpeg, and CEF. All of those dependencies have been updated. So if you are using the X264 encoder for your streams, you should actually see some performance improvements. I haven't been able to test it out yet, so we'll see how much of a performance improvement that actually is, but any improvement is good, right? It's always a good day when OBS releases a new major version. I'm definitely gonna be playing around with OBS version 24, testing it out for my stream, and reporting any bugs that I get to the OBS team. It's worth noting there's probably gonna be some hot fixes over the next couple of days, so make sure you're always updating to the latest version. If you're new to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, this is the kind of video that we do quite often, looking at streaming software, streaming hardware, all things streaming basically. So if that interests you, definitely worth checking out some of the other videos and subscribing if you haven't already. Finally, a massive thanks as always to the patrons who supported this month, helping support the Gaming Careers channel. I'll be probably releasing a video next week talking about TwitchCon because I obviously will be heading there. So keep your eyes out for that in your sub boxes and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.